We are in the Rhode Show kitchen with one of our favorite guys. Chef George is here from a great place, Portsmouth Publick House. We got corned beef. We're making look at this picture. If this doesn't scream St. Patrick's Day, I don't know what will. The two bald guys with their St. Patrick's Day hats on and making corned beef. It's perfect.
Corned beef, yes.
Corned beef. How are you?
Fantastic.
I'm going to take my hat off. Yeah.
Wait, we should be saying Edingle Bra.
Yeah, we should. All right, what do we got for this to make this tonight? I love corned beef. I love everything you got.
This is the classic, I think the classic St. Patrick's Day dish.
Right.
So simple to make. It's corned beef, carrots, parsnips or turnips, mm-hmm. potatoes, obviously cabbage, and some boiling vegetables.
And that's it.
That's it.
That's it. Now, you know
wait, I forgot the star.
You got the beer. The thing about corned beef, though, is you can buy a big piece of corned beef, and it'll shrink down to nothing. So how do you know what size to get?
You're going to lose 20%.
You are, okay.
In boiling. And then the way I make it, we're going to lose a little bit more because right from the boiling pot, I douse it in beer and I throw it in the oven to finish it off.
Yeah.
And you're going to lose a little bit more. So always figure somewhere between 20 and 30% of the corned beef is going to lose.
It's going to be gone anyway.
Yeah.
And I got to tell you, a lot of people will just boil that as it is.
Yep.
But I recently had it with the beer.
Yep.
In it later.
It's delicious.
It, you know what? It makes all the difference in the world with the flavor, the taste of it. It just tastes so good.
Well, it makes it a little bit more tender, too.
Right.
And the worst thing is that sometimes you'll have corned beef,
right,
and you know it's boiled, but as you're eating it, you're like, wow, it's dry.
Right.
It rehydrates
it. There we go. We're going to put our hats back on. It's happy St. Patrick's Day, even though it's not it yet. We're going to make this. Chef George is going to cook some this morning, and we're going to eat. Back to you.
Stay hat right now. I have to tell you, it took Chef George about, 3 minutes, the amount of time after you stopped reading the Facebook comments for him to realize that I was wearing this hat. Okay, we have a St. Patrick's Day menu on the table today.
Correct, yeah. So I've got the corned beef in the water boiling with all the spices and mm-hmm. the boiling vegetables right there. So we're going to let that boil.
How long does that go for again?
Both. 30 minutes a pound.
Okay.
So 25 to 30 minutes a pound.
Great.
So, I don't know, 45 minutes to an hour.
Good math there.
I've got my vegetables going mm-hmm. for the actual boiled vegetables.
The biggest vegetables I've ever seen, by the way.
Yeah, right?
You got some carrots.
Yeah, so carrots, potatoes, parsnips.
I know, my hat's messing you all up.
It really is. It's awesome. And then of course, the second star of the show is the cabbage.
That's just half of the cabbage.
Yeah, that's half the cabbage.
I told you, it's giant vegetables. It reminds me of the episode of Gilligan's Island when they found all those.
Oh, yeah, with the big nuclear-sized vegetables. I remember that. That's fun. And then what we're going to do is we're going to cut the cabbage right now. I don't like my cabbage overboiled. A lot of people will take the cabbage, mm-hmm. they boil everything to death, and it just, all you taste is...
You have to do it in steps.
Yeah, you do it in steps.
You're right, it will
easier.
Just fall apart.
Yeah, and so what I did is... Mm-hmm. You got your arm in the sling, so...
That's okay.
So what you want to do is you want to just take the spine out in the back right here.
Yeah, because that's just so
And that
tough.
Just pops out. And then what I like to do is I actually like to cut it in wedges. Like this.
Oh, nice.
And that way each person gets a nice little wedge of cabbage. And what we're actually going to do is when this is all done, I'm going to take the boiled vegetables, we're going to mash them together.
Mm-hmm.
And this is going to be, when it's plated, there's going to be the cabbage.
Will it stay together like that?
Yep, it should.
Oh, wow.
Yep. It's going to be mashed vegetables on top and then the corned beef. So each person gets a nice little plate of
Yum.
The corned beef and cabbage all together.
And that's such a smart idea, too, to portion everything out just by cutting the wedges and say, all right, one wedge per person.
I know, one wedge, but it's the easiest way to do it. And
there you
And you can cut them smaller. If you cut them thinner, mm-hmm. keep the spine on. Keep this thing on, because this will hold it all together.
Sounds
but,
great.
But on the big ones, it's fine.
All righty. Just like that. We have got this Irish meal started, and we're going to finish it coming up.
We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Chef George is here. Portsmouth Publick House
is
the place.
We're having so much fun.
We have a studio audience this morning. Corned beef, Publick House style is what we got going on.
Yeah.
I think it's because there's a lot of hungry people
here. That's
true.
And
it smells so good.
That's true.
My knife
what do you
is
mean?
Missing.
What
my
do you
knife
mean?
Is missing. Just I just want to grab
someone
it.
Someone walked away with a knife.
Yeah, sorry about that.
That's a knife.
So where we left off before was obviously the boiling would have to continue for another 40 minutes.
Right.
Uh-huh.
So we came prepared this morning. What you do is I take the corned beef, I pull it out of that, I put it in a baking pan.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then I take the Guinness and I pour the Guinness all over the corned beef and then I tinfoil it, put some more herbs inside of it, and I just let it roast for about a half an hour, another 30 minutes, just so the Guinness boils inside the pan.
Now, I like Guinness, but why that type of beer as opposed to something
else? Well, you could use a light beer. The problem with the light beer is sometimes when you're cooking with a light beer, you actually taste the beer versus the flavor.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So because
the Guinness is much more darker,
it's a richer.
Yeah, yeah.
It's gonna work better.
Yeah, even a coffee house porter would work, or a dark porter would work fantastic.
Okay. So
and then there we go. Here's our corned beef right here.
So how long was that then in the oven
for? This was in the oven for half an hour.
Okay.
Maybe ish. You know, and then what'll happen is that when I serve it, I like serving it with the fat on, but you can trim the fat off. I trim a lot of the fat.
Wow.
When you serve it in the restaurant.
Yeah, in the restaurant.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
You know, so what I do is I'll cut it like that. So now you got your nice and pinky.
That looks good.
Yeah.
And it's not.
And I'm sure, so trimming the fat obviously happens afterwards because you want all that flavor.
You want the flavor in there. It's really, I mean, heart healthy. You really don't want to cook with the fat on it. But for the flavor, it's Irish. I mean, you have to for St. Patrick's Day.
Absolutely.
And then the goal is that what you'd want to do is you have your big dish like this.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You want to layer it. You want to make it so it's layered. Each piece of cabbage has got a nice little piece of corned beef on here.
Okay.
Michaela, excuse me. Let me just grab
right
a plate
ahead.
Over
and
here.
And you were saying, too, that you lose about 20% of the...
Yeah, 20 to 30% of the...
For anybody who's going to the store and getting ready to buy it.
Yeah, exactly. So we're going to take like a nice little piece like this. So you want to do that.
Beautiful.
And layer some vegetables. Normally, I would mash these. I just didn't have a chance. We're having so much fun in studio today, I couldn't. You know, so you want to throw some parsnips in there, some turnips, some carrots, a little potato.
Of course.
You know, and then you get yourself a classic...
Now, would you mash them all together?
Yes.
So it would be this mix. Oh,
yeah, I would mash it. I would definitely mash it all together, and I was hoping I would be able to get to it, but
go.
We just didn't.
See, I don't think I've ever had it all. Like,
oh yeah, it's fantastic. It's fantastic. Yeah, just give them a smush, and there you go.
It's getting there.
You just mash it up and all together, and you're good to go.
All right, now the restaurant itself. Do you serve this all the time, or is
for this whole entire week we'll be serving corned beef and cabbage.
Right.
There's going to be a steady flow of people.
We're right on that main route to Newport Parade.
Nice.
So it's like we get that big wave first thing in the morning for breakfast and coffee, and then at lunchtime it's just packed. It's insane. It's insanity for like 8 hours.
That looks great. Here you go.
Yeah,
Will.
Okay. Will, I want to try this.
I'm going to give it a shot.
There.
I'm just going to grab this knife from over here.
Knife.
Okay.
There you go. And
take this too. Thank you.
Michaela, we'll get.
Oh, I
love
this.
We'll do this.
And this
rustic
is
style
a classic
right here.
Dish. I mean,
here,
on St. Patrick's
right
Day, I'm gonna take it right from here.
Now you should be tasting the Guinness, the flavoring, everything in there, and it should be very moist. Because lots of times, again, people will boil corned beef and they're like, "Oh, I'm just gonna boil it," not thinking it's gonna dry out.
And it does dry out.
It dries out.
It's
like weird because it has that weird taste. It's just so overcooked.
You're right. And this is nice. It's nice and moist.
Yep.
Plenty of flavor in there, especially too from boiling it, you know, nice and slow for a while, and then baking it
in
the Guinness.
Throw it in the oven with the Guinness
and
on top.
And I'm also somebody who likes to put mustard all over it too.
Oh yeah.
I love mustard.
I love it too.
I really.
Plenty available, I'm sure. Right. For those that are just tuning in, I know you're here every Wednesday.
Every Wednesday.
Where are you located?
600 Clock Tower Square in Portsmouth, Rhode Island.
You can't miss them, especially if you're on your way out to the parade there.
Yes, exactly.
It is so good.
You're smiling.
I am.
He's turning into a leprechaun before my eyes. He's so happy.
Well, he's got the hat. He can certainly play the part.
Just a wee bit.
Just a wee bit.
Yeah. Delicious.
That's for
All right.
Excellent. You can find this recipe on WPRI.com, and happy St. Patrick's Day.